Hello and what's up everybody, this is P. Sharma from Speed Academy, and in today's video we will be learning about the counters. Actually your counters are same as your order list. If you have all worked in the order list, then you all are familiar with how a counter will be working. Because your count, you have seen that your order list is your either in the numbers or upper alpha, lower alpha or in Romans. Similarly, we have counters designed for the styling purpose of your, you can say your lists. Means if you're working with your order list, then we can't style the numbers and the your, you can say numbers or your upper alpha in different colors or whatever we want. So for that purpose, the counter is now added to our CSS 3. It is the latest. It is a new feature of your CSS. So let me show you how it all works and how to do all this stuff. So for that I will be using a simple example of, I'm just taking some 2 or 3 headings with h1 tag, and I can write html5 for example, h1 css3 h1 your JavaScript ES6, sorry. Okay. So this ES6 is a version of JavaScript, okay? And now let me just show you the output, then we will work on the styling part, how is or add how the counter will be working and all. You can see I have 3 of the heading tags, and let me show you with the help of a flowchart that how your this counter will be going to work and what are the properties and values that we are going to deal with. So you can see this is a flowchart. I have downloaded this image from the internet, and you can see that we have one counter reset, counter and counter increment. Guys, your counter having 3 parts, okay? So first is your counter reset, which in which you have to name your counter, give the name of the counter and give the starting position of the counter, means from which position the counter will start working. As we have given in the your order list, the start part, that if we give the starting part to 5, then the counting will be starting from the 5. And similarly, you can write like this. I will be showing all that stuff in later in the video only. So just for now, you can understand that your counter reset will is the part where you name your counter and type write the starting value. If you don't type, you don't write the starting value, then it is take by default 0 and start from 1. And second part is your counter. Count, as you can see, after the counter name, you can see the counter. You can see the parenthesis, opening and closing parenthesis. So this parenthesis means your, it is a function. You can see it is a function calling functions. Okay, calling function. I'm saying because this is going to call your the counter which have you created, and going to append means append your output in your screen in your web page. Wherever you have put in the your counter, we have you assigned the counter position. So as you all know that if we want to add something to our web page without the without writing any your HTML, then we use the content property of CSS for writing or appending the your content on your web page. So you can see over here in the content part, I have write the word counter, and inside the parenthesis I have write the name of the my counter, which is the my counter. You can see over here my counter is the name of my counter. And third part is your counter increment, in which you have to write the name of the counter and the value by which every time your counter value will be going to increase. Okay, so as you can see here I have my counter is equal to 5. So first value is your 1, and second next time the value will be coming is your 1 plus 5, which is equal to 6, and another time will be your 6 plus 5 is equal to 11. So this cycle move on, as you can see over here. This is a, I have in this flowchart, you can see by the help of an arrow, this how this cycle will be moving and all. Okay, so how this all will be working, and I will be let me show you with the help of an example. I have already written using some heading over there. Okay, so now what I want that in my output, you can see that I have headings. Okay, you can see I have a headings, 3 different headings, HTML5, CSS3, and JavaScript ES6. So now what I want that my the counter will be start like at 01 or sorry 1 2 3 means number you can see should be written over there. For that what I can do, I can just do some basic stuff first. The margin, the padding, and your box sizing, box 0. And now now I'm going to create my counter, you can see. So for the creation of the counter, you have to write the word counter reset in which you have to in which you can create your counter reset. Okay, and this you have to write the name of your counter. So I'm writing the same my counter that is shown in your image, and I'm not writing any starting value, it will by default take t1 value. And now I'm gonna work with the pseudo selector, which is your before, means because I want that before means before the these heading tags. If I write after, then it will going to add the after the heading tags. Okay, so now let us call the content, because content will help you to write the name, write the counters values, and my counter. Okay, you can write any name. If you can write either my counter, or you can just write speed, for example. You have to only given the name. Okay, so I have just chosen speed for your understanding. And now I want to increment the size, increment the value of my counter. The counter increment, you have to write the name of the counter, which is speed, and by which value the counter will be going to be incremented. Now you can see in my output that 1 2 3 is written over there. But okay, you can see, let me just give some space in between there, so that I can just write that. Right, now you can see some spacing in between the, this is their counting value. So if you want to give them a styling or else, so you can also give them like that, count color and background black. So you can see how cool is look. And you can also change the format of your this numbering to upper alpha, lower alpha, or low means. For that, what you have to do, you have to come in the content part, and just after the counter name, you have to write separate the two values by comma and write the name. Just for example, I can write upper alpha, and now you can see my numbering will be AB, changing into ABCD. Similarly, you can change it to lower alpha or lower Roman or whatever you want. Now you can see it is YBCD, and now I can change it like lower Roman. But make sure the value you have written that lower Roman, then it should be not be separated. You have to put the iPhone in between that. So you can see now the counting will be starting as like this. Okay, so in this way you can add multiple counters to your website. Okay, now if I just make it like after, then you can see what the changes you will find. Then my counting will be after the this. So this is the work of your pseudo selector after and before, and how can you add the counters in your websites. So I hope you understand the topic about the concept, how your counter will be working and all. So that's all in this video.